The B. Smith described on the warrant is not the same B. Smith I spoke to this afternoon.
Oh, I don't think the department would agree with you.
Maybe not. But there's such a thing in the Crimes Act as a plea of mercy. And once a case gets that far, it normally stands a very good chance of success. And B. Smith could very well find herself released on those grounds.
Oh, come now, Doctor. This is no ordinary prisoner. This is the highly publicized B. Smith, and the charge is murder.
True. But consider this. B. Smith, in her present state, is as rehabilitated as she's ever going to get.
Well, you could cure her, surely.
That's always possible, yes. But here's the dilemma. Should I? The woman I spoke to this afternoon is an innocent woman. Innocent of any crime. She hates violence. Now, should I try and bring her out of it? Should I bring back B. Smith murderess? Or should I leave her as she is and argue for an early release?
Are you all right? I don't know. I don't feel all that good.
Well, perhaps you better stay there.
No. I'll be all right. You go on, have a shower. I'll wander down in a moment.
You sure?
Yes. Yes, go on, off you go.
Okay. I'll see you up there.
Yes, okay.
Mum? Oh, God. Help! Help! Somebody help me! Help! Where is everybody? Help! I need help!
Hold that racket, Smith. What's all...
It's Mum. She's collapsed. I came back from the showers. I found her in the cell.
Stand back from the gate.
Come on. Will you hurry up? She said she wasn't well this morning. I shouldn't have left her on her own.
Mrs. Brooks? Mrs. Brooks? Where are tablets?
She keeps them over here.
Find them. They must have pulled them down behind there somewhere. Now, there's no time. Just go down and get the sifter. Tell her what happened and tell us to bring some insulin.
Oh, where is it?
Where's what?
The hospital.
Oh, for God's sake, Smith, there's no time for this nonsense. Go and get the sister.
I don't know where it is.
Listen, Smith, this woman's supposed to be your friend. You want
her
to die?
Please, believe me, I've never been to the hospital. I don't know where it is.
You stay here. Don't you dare leave here before I get back. Do you understand?
Friend Lou,
where did you get those?
I sort of borrowed them last night.
Oh, that's why she's backed out. She didn't have her dose last night. Give those pills to me or
I'll... Oh, you'll what? Feel like taking on the three of us?
Look, you don't understand. She's a diabetic. She could die.
Tough. You could always try and take them back off us. What's up? Guts gone to Jelly Bee. Ex-Queen Bee with the royal jelly belly. Hey, we gotta go now. I don't have to warn you about keeping your trap shut about these, do I? You above all know what happens to laggards.
Out of the way, Smith.
What's the trouble?
The pills that she was issued with last night are missing. That's why she's blacked out.
But they aren't missing. They were stolen.
Now, we can't jump to conclusions, Smith. She might have forgotten where she left
But
them.
They were stolen, I know.
Oh, come on, Smith. What sort of an animal would do something like that?
Well, animal's right. It was that Margot woman. She was standing at the door just a few minutes before you arrived, tossing the pills in the air and daring me to do something about it.
If what you say is true, the staff will handle it. I do not want the prisoners involved.
But it is true. She was here just a few seconds ago with the pills. If you go after her now, you'll catch her with them on her.
All right, Gaffney, where are they?
Where's what?
Mrs. Brooks' pills.
Pills? What are you talking about?
Don't play around, Gaffney. This is a very serious matter. She's unconscious because she didn't take her pills in time.
It's hardly my fault, is it?
She didn't take them because they weren't there. We believe you stole them.
Bull. You've got to be careful who you get your information from these days.
Some of your sources aren't as reliable as they used to be.
Search the cell, Mr. Fletcher.
Get off this girl.
You'd better be as innocent as you make out, because if we didn't get to Mum in time and she doesn't regain consciousness, whoever stole those pills is going to be up on a murder charge.
Even if I did steal them, hardly matter to me, would it? I'm never going to get out of this joint anyway. And even if I did get out, the cops would only hound me until they had me back here inside. Out there, I'm a loser. In here, I intend to be a winner.
The only way you'll be a winner in here is to behave yourself and stick to the rules. You can go back to your cell now.
But I won't wait to see me find the pills.
Go back to your cell. You've absolutely no reason to be in here.
Well, if she did have them, they're not here now. Not that that surprises me. Just watch your step, Gaffney. I'll be keeping my eye on you.
Drop in any time, Fletch. Door's always open.
Getting rid of the evidence.
Get lost. I'll deal with you later.
No, you'll deal with me now. What sort of monster are you? Taking a diabetic's pills. What's she ever done to you?
Don't give me the hearts and flowers bit. You know the system better than anyone else. She crossed me. I warned her I'd get her.
I don't know what system you're talking about, but if it includes letting an ill woman die because she can't take her medicine, then it ought to be changed.
You're really one for the books, you know, Smith. What's got into you? You found God or something?
No, I found hell. Now, you're coming with me and you're going to bring those pills.
Where to?
The governor's office.
Now, listen to me, you lagging bitch. I don't know what your little scheme is and I don't care. So if you think you're taking me to the governor's office or anywhere else for that matter, you're in for one hell of a shock.
You come with me if I have to drag you.
You have slipped your trolley. You have gone right over the edge. They're going to have to redecorate your cell with padded walls. I'd get lost before I cream you.
Listen!
Not as easy as you thought, eh, big shot?
You're crazy.
Get off me!
No, I'm not.
Get off. What's going on in here? Get up! Smith, get up! Now give me an explanation.
This maniac tried to kill me.
I found her with Mum's pills. She was going to flush them down the sink.
Found them. I was about to take them back, and this lunatic rushes in about screaming.
All right. Give me the pills. Get back to your cell, Smith. Any more of this, and you'll both do a stint in solitary. Now get out. Where did you get the pills?
Oh, I found them under a chair in the rec room. Must have fallen out of her pocket while she was watching telly last night.
I found the missing pills.
Oh, thanks, Miss Bennett. I've already given her a dose, but it'll take a while before it has any effect.
How is she now?
I think she's going to be all right. It's lucky we caught her in time. I've called the doctor in to give her a check over, just to make sure.
Where'd you find the pills?
I've just broken up a fight between Smith and Gaffney. Smith says that she called Gaffney trying to get rid of the pills down the sink. Gaffney says that she found the pills in the rec room and was on her way to give them back when Smith attacked her.
Well, who do you think's telling the truth?
Knowing those two, probably neither.
Yeah. Well, you better tell Mrs. Davison we found the pills.
Right.
Well, there's not much more I can do around here.
I thought we might do a quick check of the drug cabinet.
Sorry, Alson. I just remembered. I've got to take a quick inventory of the storeroom.
More likely you're checking on how high your stocks are with Vera. Well, you take it easy, old son.
Well, a bet's a bet.
Cold. Cold.
It's all right, sister. I can handle it.
Vera, it's all right, I'll go.
Thank you.
Oh, you didn't waste any time in finding those pills. So I handed it to you.
I've had experience with Smith and Gaffney.
Well, I must say I don't agree with you about B. Smith. I know you told me what she was like before she went to Barnhurst, but she seems so different now.
Believe me, she's just the same. She's only trying to put one over on us.
Well, I'm not so sure. I mean, she could have lost her memory in that car crash. I mean, if she's faking, she's doing a damn good job.
Come on, Terry, you've worked with these sort of people before. You know what they're capable of.
Yeah, well, maybe you're right. I mean, after all, I'm just a babe who needs educating as far as you women are concerned.
Well, that's a rough guess. I think you've probably passed your exams on that subject.
Yeah, I'm willing to do a bit of it.
What do you think you're doing here, Burns?
Oh, I'm collecting the laundry. That's why I've got the trolley.
Well, get on with it then.
I can't until someone opens the gate, Miss Bennett.
Oh.
Oh, it's all right, I'll
Well, at least they've been found, but we're still no closer to knowing what really happened.
I guess we'll never know.
You say they were fighting and Smith actually had the upper hand when you went into the cell.
Yes.
Well, normally that wouldn't surprise me, but considering Smith's recent behavior and Dr. Weissman's report...
Why is everyone so ready to believe that Smith has changed? You know what she's like.
Usually I would agree with you, but after examining her, Dr. Weissman is of the opinion that she is suffering from amnesia.
Oh, I can't believe that. She's fooled him, too.
And in his professional opinion, if she does not regain her memory in a short while and they find brain damage, then she could appeal for mercy and probably be released.
She's killed two people. Do you mean to say that she could walk out of here free?
That's not impossible. Mentally, she is not the same woman who committed those murders. Therefore, the punishment would have no value. No meaning.
She's a criminal. If she's changed so much, why do you think she attacked Gaffney?
I admit that did surprise me. But we don't know how far she was pushed.
It doesn't matter. If they let her out and she's pushed too far again, she wouldn't hesitate to kill.
You may be right. But we are not qualified to make medical judgments.
Maybe not. But I know B. Smith. She's trying to fool everyone into believing she's lost her memory so she can get an early release. And sooner or later, I'm going to prove it.
Hey, B. I just heard about you getting stuck in the Margot for pinching Mum's pills. That was real terrific, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah, it's terrific, isn't it? Doesn't take long to stoop to their level, does it?
What are you talking about? I reckon it's great that you're back on form again. I mean, having Margot on top of the pile was getting to be a real pain in the neck.
What do you mean?
Well, I don't mind telling you that you had us going for a while, you know, with that losing your memory bit. And even some of the screws weren't sure whether you were for real or not. But you've really blown it now that you've shown Margot who's the real boss. Why were you doing it, B? I mean, you can tell us now. Well, some of the women, well, they reckoned that you were doing it so you could get transferred to a real cushy nursing home.
Look, who do you think you are bursting in here talking to me like this? I hardly even know you. I don't know what you mean by taking over from Margot.
But,
look, I don't understand any of you. I tried to punish her for what she did to Mrs. Brooks. I didn't mean to do it myself. I just lost my temper. Everything happened so fast. Look, I shouldn't even be in here. Will you please just go away and leave me alone?
Well, B, if that's the way you want it. I thought we were real good friends, and I thought we trusted each other. I mean, we've been through a lot together, you and me and Lizzie and Judy. And when we all nearly died down that drain, well, we sort of made ourselves into a club, you know, a family. And now it looks as though you want to go out on your own without us.
Please, will you go away?
You're not putting us on, are you? You don't remember, do you? Something's happened to you, B.
Nothing's happened to her. She's not your friend or anybody's. This time the stakes are too high, aren't they, Smith? And what are you doing here, Burns? You should be in the laundry.
I told you...
Don't you answer me back. Just get on with your work. As for you, Smith, you don't fool me for a minute. You may well have fooled Dr. Weissman, but I want you to know I'm on to you. You're wasting your time. You belong in here. And believe me, I'm going to make sure you stay. I told you to get to the laundry, Burns. You too, Gaffney. Now move.
Vinegar Tits is wrong. I reckon B's right off the planet. One more screw loose and she would rattle. Now, we couldn't have someone like that as boss round here, could we? And to prove my point, she's going to have to pay for today's little effort.
Don't hurt her, Margot. She's sick.
She's gonna be a lot sicker when I've finished with her.
And recently there was a case where a prisoner lost his memory, made an appeal for mercy, and the court released him.
Oh, I really can't follow some of their decisions.
Oh, I suppose what they're saying is that a person is imprisoned as punishment for committing a crime, not to stop them from doing it again. If they can't remember committing the crimes, well, I suppose it's like imprisoning an innocent person. Now, the same could apply to Smith.
That's absolutely ridiculous. B. Smith has killed twice. The second one was definitely premeditated. If she's provoked, she'll kill again.
Yeah, but if she has amnesia, she's not the same person we know. Mentally, she's not the same person who committed the killings.
She's conning you, and you're fools if you can't see through it.
How's Brooks doing now?
Oh, she seems to be recovering. The doctor who examined her once had kept her in the hospital overnight just to be on the safe side.
Oh, I suppose you want her released too, seeing she's in for harbouring a criminal who magically no longer exists.
Well, actually, that's a very good point, Vera. I'll keep that in mind. Em, Cole, Terry, come on, Cole. Our turn to mind the shop.
All right.
Jim been ruffling your feathers, has he?
Oh, this whole place is. B. Smith has fooled everyone into believing she's lost her memory. Even Dr. Weissman's been taken in. And you.
Look, let's forget about B. Smith and Dr. Weissman and everybody else. Let's just think about you and me.
What do you have in mind?
Well, I think we deserve a break from this place, you and I, don't you? Tonight, dinner, what do you say?
Well,
what are you doing there, Lizzie?
Oh, sorry, Mr. Harrison. I got him up this floor.
Yeah, well, do it later. Can't you see the room's occupied?
I got him up it now. Do it later, Lizzie. Yes, later. Oh, sorry.
Well, we can't get away from them, can we?
You still haven't. Just a minute. What are you hanging about for, Birdsworth? Go and do the kitchens.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
Well, Miss Bennett, you'll have to give me a refresher course. I seem to have forgotten that walls have ears.
That's why I've always kept my private life outside the prison. The women would love to exploit any relationship between the staff.
But you're not going to let them stop you having a good time when you're off duty, are you?
No, of course not. I'm just saying that it's wise not to give them an opportunity to entertain themselves at our expense.
Oh, come on, they can't be that bad.
They're not very intelligent, but they're cunning. You can't trust any of them. Take Birdsworth. She'll go blabbing about anything she's seen or heard. And in no time, the women will have concocted some incredible story about us.
Well, if they're going to have a good time, why shouldn't we? Oh, come on. Can't you forget you're a prison officer for one night and have a good time?
It's just not wise. If they found out about it, we'd have no control over them.
Well, who's going to tell them? I'm not. Are you?
No, no.
Well, here you are, then. Do I have to ask you again to go out with me?
Well, after a day like this one, I certainly need a change of scenery. Well, yes, I'd love to have dinner with you.
Good, that's settled. I'll pick up at 7:30.
Aye, watch where you're going, would you?
You maybe drop the seat.
I think you're doing.
Hey, doll. Guess what I just heard?
What?
Come on, have a guess.
Vinegar Tits is having twins.
No, but the next best thing. They're going out to dinner.
Who are?
Vera and the new screw, Harrison. I heard him talking in the staff room. And he asked her and she said yes.
Oh, God, it looks like we've cracked it for another weirdo.
Suppose they're only human.
Who, Vera? Come to think of it, I did see them talking to each other in the corridor a little while ago and they looked real guilty when they realised I was there. I think he's real cute. Must be weak on top, but
if she's happy, it might make it easier for us.
Yeah, and on poor old B.
Well, what's happened now?
Well, Vera caught me in B's cell and she threw me out. Then she went on at B about this amnesia bit. And it looks like even most of the screws think there's something wrong with B. But Vera reckons she's faking just so they'll let her out.
Well, B knows what she's up to. I knew she had something up her sleeve and she'll pull it off.
Yeah, but Lizzie, Vera says that even Dr. Weissman believes it too, and he's a psychiatrist. And all I can say is that it wasn't the old B that I was talking to this morning.
Oh, don't worry. B knows what she's doing, and she'll do it too. And for God's sake, don't let Margot know anything about it, because she'll screw everything up for me proper.
Good thinking. Well, cheers. What's the matter?
Nothing.
Why are you staring at me?
I was just wondering, why me?
Why you what?
Well, you wouldn't have trouble getting any girl to go out with you. You must have dozens to choose from.
Oh, don't you believe it. Being a prison officer has its drawbacks. It's not all glamour, you know. I mean, there's shift work, overtime, strange hours.
Yes, I know what you mean. It can be a lonely profession.
Oh, don't get me wrong. I enjoy my work. And it does have its compensations. Well, like tonight, for instance. Being out with a nice lady prison officer. Come on, let's order. I'm starving.
Mrs. Brooks. Mrs. Brooks, come on. It's time for your pills. Come on, wake up. Mrs. Brooks?
You're a prison officer.
Yes, my name's Fletcher.
What am I doing here?
You collapsed in your cell.
Cell?
You're in the prison hospital.
Prison?
Yes, Wentworth. Don't you remember?
Oh, yes, of course. So it wasn't all a dream.
No, I'm afraid not. Now, come on. It's time for your pills.
How long have you been at Wentworth? You weren't here when I was in before.
No, I arrived just after you were released.
What an awful job, having to roam around this place all night.
Well, somebody has to do it.
You should be at home with your family.
Well, I don't have a family anymore, so I don't mind, really.
If you didn't have such a terrible job, they probably wouldn't have left you.
Yes, you're right in a way, but, well, they didn't leave me like that. They were killed.
Oh. Oh, I'm so sorry. Thank you for thinking of my pills.
How are you feeling now?
Oh, I'm fine.
Well, you better get some sleep then.
Yes. Good night.
Good night, Mum.
That was a delicious meal. Thank you for asking me, Terry.
Yes, it was nice. Made even more enjoyable by your delightful company.
I can't be bothered cooking for myself much.
No, me neither. Good cooking should be shared by a good wine and a pretty lady.
You manage the wine.
I think you're very pretty. Especially when you smile like that. You don't do that at work.
I don't have much cause. Anyway, I thought we decided not to talk about work.
Sorry. Well, it's just that you're so different away from the place. Anyway, you were talking about my girlfriends. What about you? I bet there are dozens of blokes beating a path to your door.
Oh, hundreds. It's a wonder you didn't see them when you came to pick me up.
No special man?
Oh, there have been opportunities. But like you, it interferes with my work, and my work must come first.
Anybody who takes that as an answer doesn't deserve you.
But I really must be going home.
Look, you sure you wouldn't like to go somewhere else?
Oh, no, I must be getting to bed. I mean, no.
I know what you mean. I'll get the check.
Thank you very much for a wonderful evening, Terry.
Well, thank you. I can't remember when I enjoyed myself more. Mind you, you took your time in deciding to go out with me.
I wish now I'd agreed earlier.
Well, you're playing hard to get.
Oh, no. I just thought it was a game to you. A challenge to break me down.
Well, I may have been just flirting at first, but... Well, now it's different. It's a whole lot different. Well, good night.
Look, it's a bit cold out here. Why don't you come in for a cup of coffee? Warm yourself up for the trip home.
Well, another time I'd love to, but, well, not tonight. All right? Good night.
Morning.
Oh, hi.
Not exactly bright-eyed or bushy-tailed this morning, are we? What happened? Let's see. I know, you left your butter in the fridge last night and it was too hard to spread in your toast this morning. Huh. Yes? No? Well, in that case, it must be Vera Bennett.
Look, Jim, about that stupid bet. Looks like you were right. You win.
Oh, come on, mate. You're not giving up so easily, are you? Not
afraid
you.
Afraid so. Hate to admit it, but there's your $20.
Well, well, well. Thought I'd never live to see it. How about that then, eh?
Yeah, well, you've had your laugh. Just don't go on about it. It was a rotten thing to do in the first place.
Well, I warned you, mate. You'd have your work cut out for you. If everybody else has a heart, Vera Bennett has a prison door.
Yeah, well, I don't agree with you, Vera. I think she's quite a nice lady.
Don't tell me the Iron Lady's getting to you, is she, mate?
Well, of course not. Well, let's just drop the whole thing, all right? For good.
Yeah, sure.
Anyway, I've gone back to duty.
What was all that about?
What?
Well, I obviously interrupted something just now when I came in. I suppose you were talking about your latest conquests.
No, no, as a matter of fact, Terry was just paying me back some money that he owed me. No, Terry never talks about his private life. He's more of the old-fashioned gentleman type, really.
But it'd surprise me with any man these days.
Come in. Ah, good morning, Nick. You're early.
Miss Morris.
How's the job hunting going?
Nothing as usual.
Well, I think I've got some good news for you. I spent most of yesterday ringing up my contacts, and late yesterday afternoon it paid off. You've been offered a job as a packer in a warehouse. How do you feel about that?
Oh, it's great.
Good. Well, you're to go to this address and ask for a Mr. Sutton.
Right. Well, thanks very much for going to all the trouble.
All part of the service.
Wait for me by the gates. How are you feeling now, Mum?
Oh, very much better. Still a little weak, but otherwise I'm fine.
That's good. Now you look after yourself now.
Yes, I will. Mr. Fletcher, I really am sorry talking about your family like that last night.
Oh, that's all right. You want to know. Besides, it's a long time ago now.
You seem to work long hours. You were here late last night and again early this morning. Do you need the overtime so much?
No, 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 not really. It's better than being stuck at home alone.
Oh, surely there must be better things to do. Other jobs. Unless you need the security.
No, 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 I don't need much of that anymore. No, the job's not that bad. Besides, once you've been out of the mainstream for a while, you find that you're not equipped for much else.
Yes, I suppose so. But friends. You must have some friends on the outside.
Yes, one or two. But what about you? I haven't noticed that you've been exactly swamped with visitors since you arrived.
No, I'm pretty much a loner now. I do have a family, but they don't know I'm back in here. I told them I was going away for a holiday. We're not close anymore. No, Bea and a couple of the others are about the only friends I have now.
How did you become friendly with her? I mean, you're so unalike. She's hard and conniving.
She might appear so, but no one's bad all the way through. And she's always been very good to me. She's looked after me. Are you trying to pump me to find out whether she's lying about losing her memory?
No, of course not.
Well, she isn't. You should have seen her when she came to me. She was sick. She collapsed. I couldn't turn her in while she was like that. I had to try and help her get better. Well, surely they can't lock me up for that. Mrs. Morris doesn't think so.
Well, unfortunately, they can. And it's up to the courts to decide if there's any mitigating circumstances.
What's that supposed to mean? Someone trying to help a sick friend.
Carrie? Samantha? Hey, get out of bed, Romeo, will you? Hey. Hey, what's wrong?
It's Gary. The cops have got him.
Hey?
I went down to have lunch with him at the pub, and when I got there, he was being bundled into a van with some other guys. Busted for possession. What the hell are we going to do?
Don't worry about it. I know someone who can help.
Who? Perry Mason?
A contact of mine with the law. I'll give her a ring.
What are you going to do? Offer her your body?
Not that desperate. Not yet.
Detective Sergeant Rouse, please. Oh, Detective, it's Meg Morris speaking. Oh, I'm very well, thank you. I'm rather anxious to talk to you about the B. Smith Mum Brooks case. Yes, I know that, but Yes, I do understand, but there are certain new aspects that have come to hand that I think you should know about. And I'd rather not talk to you about them over the phone. Yes, well, I thought you'd rather hear them from me personally than find out about them at the hearing. Well, I could come over straight away. Yes, I'll be there in a few minutes. Gotcha.
Look, check that address, will you? Well, Mrs. Morris, what's this mysterious new evidence?
But first of all, why has Mrs. Brooks been arrested?
Mrs. Morris, I shouldn't have to explain that to you. She was aiding and abetting an escaping felon. She was caught red-handed giving Smith money, and on top of that, she's still on parole. God, what more do you want?
Oh, technically, yes, that's all true. But there are extenuating circumstances.
Aye, now comes the new evidence.
B. Smith has amnesia. This was caused by the crash while she was being transferred from Barnhurst.
Of course, she'd say she'd lost her memory. Now she's been recaptured. You can't expect anyone to take her seriously.
But we have professional psychiatric evidence.
Yeah, I'll bet Smith made sure of that.
After the crash, the only thing that Smith could remember was Mum Brooks's address. When she finally found Mrs. Brooks' house, Smith collapsed. Mrs. Brooks was just helping a sick friend. Now, surely she shouldn't be in prison for that.
Smith wasn't looking too sick when she was taking the money Brooks was handing to her.
Couldn't you drop the charges? She's a harmless old woman.
Mrs. Morris, I am fed up with you do-gooders. Smith's got out before and she'll try again. And anybody who helps her's got to know what they're in for. No, I will not drop the charges. They'll be made an example of. We'll slam them both and we'll slam them hard. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Hello, everybody.
Hi. How'd you get on with Sergeant Rouse? Did he bring out the thumb screws and the rubber hoses?
How did you know I'd been to see him?
Mrs. Brooks told me. She said you're going to try and get him to drop the charges against her.
Yes, well, it didn't work. He's going to make an example of them both. We'll slam them and we'll slam them hard.
It's going to be very hard on Mrs. Brooks.
Yes, and on B, especially if they won't accept Dr. Wiseman's diagnosis. Well, I better go and tell them what's happened.
Yeah, well, B's not on laundry duty, so you'll probably find them both in their cell.
Right. Oh, Jim, there's some advice I want from you. I was wondering whether you could help me.
Sure, if I can.
It's one of my probationers. Oh, he's a nice kid, but he's had emotional problems at home and's got in with the wrong crowd. I've managed to get him a job as a packer at a warehouse, but I don't know how long it'll last. What he needs is emotional security, a sense of belonging.
At the risk of sounding a bit old-fashioned and right-wing, how about one of the forces? He'd certainly have a sense of belonging there, and he could probably learn a trade as well.
Yes, I suppose so. Yes, well, I'll put it to him, but I don't know whether he'll accept it or not. It may be too establishment for him.
Hello, Meg.
Oh, hello, Vera.
Where's Terry?
How should I know?
Well, every time I look for him these days, he's usually just three paces behind you.
I don't know what you're talking about.
He must be lost. I'd better go and find him.
Now, what was all that about?
He's practicing to be the resident idiot.
This new officer, Terry, is he giving you a hard time?
No, not really. He's very nice. That's the trouble.
Oh, I see.
Well, it's nothing serious yet. I've been out with him a couple of times. But it's so confusing. He's paying me so much attention.
Well, what's wrong with that? I thought you'd be pleased.
Well, I am, but it's all so fast. Why me? He's really a very attractive man.
Now, why not you?
I'm just frightened, Meg. You know, my private life has ended up in the past.
Right, we don't have much time. Get in there, work her over like she'll never forget, and get out fast.
Right, what are you three up to?
Nothing, Mr. Fletcher. Just having a bit of a chat, you know. No harm in that.
Anyone else but you three, maybe not. I'll be back this way in a couple of minutes. I better not find any of you hanging around, you understand?
Right, we can't do the job with Fletcher on patrol. But one way or the other, I am going to get her. No matter who she thinks she is. Queen Bee or just plain Mrs. Smith.
Right.
Mind if I join you?
Please do.
I just saw Vera in reception. She wasn't looking too happy either.
You actually used to be pretty good friends when you were working here, weren't you?
Yes. Oh, we had our differences, but we were good friends.
You still are.
Yes, she's pretty hard to fathom. Sometimes she's as hard as nails. Other times, especially when she's away from here, she's quite vulnerable.
Well, she's got to know where she stands. She doesn't want to feel as though she's just being used.
Well, she isn't.
Well, talk to her, Terry. Convince her. She's had a couple of disastrous relationships. You can't blame her if she's a little too careful.
No, I suppose not. Well, excuse me, I've got to get back to work.
Yes, of course.
Hello?
Oh, hello. Can I speak to Mrs. Morris, please?
Yeah, she's right here. Just a minute. Excuse me.
Come
here.
Okay. Hello?
Oh, hello, Mrs. Morris. It's Nick Clark here.
Oh, yes, Nick.
Your office told me I could get you at the prison. I was wondering, I've got a bit of a problem. You remember my friend Gary?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, he's been busted.
Nick, you weren't with him?
No.
Oh, thank God for that.
Yeah, well, he's really in trouble. Do you think you could have a word to the police and see if you could get him off?
Nick, that is impossible. Illegal possession of drugs is far more serious than abusive language.
Besides, I've no official connection with the case. I'm sorry, there's nothing I can do.
Yeah, but at least you could try.
Nick, there is nothing I can do.
Oh. Great. Forget it.
Miss Bennett, can I speak to you a minute, please?
This has got nothing to do with you lot. Just get on with your work.
Vera, I've got to talk to you about last night.
Well, there's nothing to talk about. It was a very pleasant evening.
Yeah. Look, Vera, it's been on my mind all the day. That's why I've been avoiding you. I've got a conscience problem.
Conscience?
Yeah. Look, Vera, last night I wanted to stay, but I couldn't. It wouldn't have seemed right.
Are you trying to tell me that you're married?
Married? No, I'm not married.
Then I don't see why you should have anything on your conscience.
I didn't want you to think that I was just after a one-night stand. You mean more to me than that.
I see. I didn't want you to leave so soon. And when you did, I must admit I was hurt.
I'm sorry.
Well, that's all right now. I understand.
All right, you women, what are you looking at? Come on, get back to work.
What are you two doing around here? Beat it, would you?
Come on, Mrs. Smith, we got something real special for you.
What's been going on?
Bea? Oh, Mum, I was just going... What a mess! What's happened?
Oh, nothing. Bea's just got a bit sloppy, that's all. Did you want to see me about something?
Yes, I did, but I'm afraid it's not very good news. I went to see Detective Sergeant Rouse, as I promised, and I'm afraid I didn't do any good. He absolutely refuses to drop the charges against you.
Oh, I'm not surprised. You should have saved yourself the trouble.
Doesn't sound like you, Mum.
Oh, well, I'm getting on. One learns to accept things. After all, I didn't expect anything different. Why should I?
But they're wrong. You were only trying to help, and you came to me.
But it doesn't matter. After all, I did take her in, and I'd do it again. And I know that I'd get arrested again. It's just one of those things.
You sound like you've given up.
Oh, no, not really. I've just learned to accept things, that's all.
Well, you'd better start planning for your defense.
Yes, I suppose so. Although at the moment, Bea needs me in here more than my family or anyone out there. You'll have to excuse me now. It's time for muster.
All right, come on, line up. Quickly now.
Bee? I thought she was with you. No, I went back to the cellar, was in a terrible mess, and Bee wasn't there.
Bee's missing.
What? No, she couldn't be. She's probably gone off to the infirmary with Lizzie.
What's wrong with Lizzie?
Oh, nothing much. A touch of gas.
Come on, settle down. Quiet.
Maybe Bee's done a bunk.
I don't think so. I would have known. I'm terribly worried about her.
Quiet, Brooks. Where's Smith?
What's the hold-up?
Smith's missing again. All right, you'll all be locking yourselves until we find her. Come on, move.
Come on, hurry.
Master them and the others out of their
cells. She'll be all right.
Yeah, she'll be all right, Brian. I'll take her to see the sister and then the governor.
Now, come on, will you move out? Will you shut up and get going?
But you must have some idea who it was.
I never had a chance. They came at me from behind.
Yes, but surely you saw them at some stage. You must have.
No, honestly, Mr. Fletcher, it all happened so fast. It was just a blur of arms and feet. Then I passed out. And I woke up on the floor of that awful storeroom.
Well, it's obvious somebody has it in for you, and if you can't or won't help us, I have no alternative but to lock you up for your own protection. Mr. Fletcher, Smith will be confined to her cell until further notice.
Oh, is everything quietened down?
Yeah.
How's Smith?
Oh, she's a bit battered and bruised, but she'll be all right. She's been locked in a cell for her own protection.
Has she any idea who did it?
No, she said it all happened too fast. By the way, you're stopping at the pub for a few drinks on the way home?
No, I'm giving Vera a lift home.
Well, at last you're doing something concrete about it. Here.
Hmm?
There are some bets that should never be made.
Yes, you're right, but you sure? I mean, a bet's a bet. I'm no welcher.
Well, I'm glad to hear that. What are you two up to?
Oh, I'm just
asking Terry to place...
Look, it's a bit complicated. I'll explain later. Well, I won't keep you, Jim.
Yeah, right. Mm.
Well, now that we're alone, what would you like to do this evening?
How you feeling, Mrs. Smith? A bit sore, are you? How'd you like your little rest in the storeroom?
Look, I understand you. Why don't you just leave me alone? What do you want?
I want you to know I'm the boss. And if I get any more trouble out of you, I'll arrange another little party for you.
Already, Margot!
Well, thanks for the bashing, because that's just what I needed, a thump on the head, and neither of us knew it. Oh, yes, Margot, I'm back. The funny thing is, we're the only two that know it, and we're going to keep it that way. Because if I play my cards right, I'm going to get out of here for good. No, we are going to keep my little secret, aren't we? Because if you don't, so help me, I'll kill you. I'll kill you.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare.